for the reinstallation of the heritage. So that is the history. Teaching history as a somnolent lullaby is also possible by most of the teachers. But awakening the society is also the same history. Somebody asked me, what will you think when you read about your heritage? I told that I will have three feelings. The first is pride that I am belonging to that heritage. Second thing is pity that it is in such a deplorable condition. Third thing is shame that I have not sufficiently worked for it. So this is what we should have in our minds. And we are expecting two things. There are only two possibilities. One, a mega negative force should trample on the society so that they will get some awakening. Or a mega positive force should be landing on the society. Maybe they will get that enlightenment. Either that awakening or enlightenment, a mega positive or negative, it will be immediately landed on this earth, landed on this holy earth, which is known as Karma Bhumi. That's why I told in one seminar that just as we are having thorium content and also uranium deposit, we have water facilities in one part of the earth and another part of the earth we don't have. So in minerals, in various other essentialities like gems, like various gold and other things, we see mines in particular places and we don't see them in the other parts of the place. Likewise, India is the birthplace of civilization. India is the birthplace of divinity. India is the Karma Bhumi. It is the birthplace of universal knowledge, love and eternity. So it is naturally given by that. So India, by its widened arms, it has to invite and embrace all the other people. That is the duty. That is India's century mission. Moreover, we have conducted innumerable seminars and whatever we are sounding, whether people listen as they are becoming carriers and conductors to the society or not, God is hearing and He is vigilantly observing our sincere efforts. Only on that belief, I hope that it will happen soon. Narayan, Narayan.
If power comes in a man, then he will use up in three ways. Like one can destroy the world, one can improve his development, and one can use for our society. Then if his mental position is not balancing of that power, then how can he balance, or how can he came in equilibrium stage to handle his power?
It is known as lesha prapti. If somebody is speaking in an auditorium about something, there is a small spark. It is a sample. It should make you, it should drive you, if you are really interested, sincerely interested, that should intervene in your routine habit to meet such persons to discuss more. That is known as anuvartana, or it is known as anusmriti. Whatever you hear from me today, you have to rethink it several times. That is anusmriti. You have to follow me or people like me and hear several times. This lesha prapti will lead you to shastra prapti. You can go inside shastras. If you read more shastras, more books, you can get a little bit of clarification, which will make you to understand about your guru and reach. If you understand your guru, he will take you to the pathway of solution. So whatever, you cannot get everything from a single lecture. And what you want is a product of a sincere practice of several years. How to control your mind on how to be happy? It is a very simple question, and I can also answer in two or three different models. But this thing is totally useless, because it is a way of life. It is an art of life. The only problem in the society, which I want to say, is somebody asked me why we have been invaded and what is the reason for our destruction. Simply, I will put it in two or three sentences. At first, there was Vidya Parampara, whereby great yogis, they practiced spiritual methodologies and were very powerful. That is known as Vidya Parampara or Year of Vidyas. They practiced really with penance and austerity and they were very powerful. Then gradually they degraded and they kept the Shastra Parampara. They were just making a lot of quarrels and debates about this came first or that came first, it came from that hen or hen came from. These type of various other unwanted dry, these debates are done by the Shastra Parampara and that was totally polluted and diluted. Then came the mild Kala Parampara, wherein people were interested in architecture, art, there's various other forms like dance and other things. They have become very mild and soft, easily malleable and fragile for any invasion. So the Vidya Parampara has lost and Shastra Parampara came, which was just in words. Now then it has transformed into Kala Parampara, where people were very much in aesthetic sense and gratifications. Now it is in Bhasha Parampara, just we are talking about everything. So we have to come back to Shastra Parampara. If you want to get your mind in control, it is a practice of 10 years. But we should start it from today.